What's going on, folks? Welcome to another how to play video, or how I play it, really, I guess you could say. And so we broke out the Wolfgang Standard today in this beautiful kind of, I don't know, man, tri-fade quilt kind of deal. Anyway, today we're going to work on Rebel Yell, all right? So this might be a little bit more advanced. If you haven't been playing for, you know, only like a month or something, you might not want to mess with this just yet. But then again, you might can pick up some cool things from it. I don't know. I mean, you know, disclaimer right up front. You know, I play things I've learned all through my life by ear. And nowadays with, you know, you can look on YouTube and learn how to play some things, which has helped tremendously. There are certain ways that I play things. It might not be note for note. But playing guitar is all about having fun, right? As long as you're not playing really, really bad stuff, notes in particular, you know, and you're in the ballpark, I think it's good enough to pass. You know, that's just me, all right? So anyway, here are the chords for Rebel Yell that we're going to use, all right? So you're going to be in this B right here. This is just, I'm just going over some of the chords. So you see all the chords in the song. It's not that many at all. So there's going to be a B power chord on the A on the second fret. And then on the fourth, with the ring finger on the D, and also again on the G. So you got a power chord here, and then an A, then a G, then an E. That's going to be your chords pretty much for the song. And it pretty much stays in that realm. Billy Idol, one of his biggest hits here. Steve Stevens on guitar, which is Steve Stevens, unbelievable. I can't touch anything he's doing. So, you know, I just try to play it the way that works for me. And, you know, you can play things more than one way on guitar. It doesn't have to be one particular way. As long as we're all in the same, we end up at the same area, which is, you know, playing the song, all right, to, you know, people can make it out. All right, so anyway, the song starts off with a keyboard intro, and I've seen in tab books where they have you do it, the keyboard part. I can't do that, so, you know, it's just, there's too much going on for that. You, it's like your fingers are doing this one thing, and your thumb's doing this pedal kind of, you know, I don't... There's just all this crazy stuff going on. I can't do that. So I do the bass line is what I do. And it's going to be on the A string and the D string. All right. So we're going to be on the second fret A string. And then we're going, I use my pinky to go to the fifth. All right. And then on the D string on the third and fourth. All right. Now here comes the percussive thing I was talking about in the other videos. You know, you got to have a little bit of, see that right there? Not, I mean, I guess you could do downstrokes, but it's really hard on your wrist. So what I do the, I guess the bass line, like I said, it's going to be a, all right, so that's two on the A string. 2, 5, then on the D, 2 and 4. That's that part. And right after that, it goes into like this, it goes to a G, and it just kind of steps down, as I would say. So it goes on the low E, you're on the third fret. Up and down picking, and then we go to the second fret, and then the open E. All right, so if you put it together, it's going to be like this. I like to do an E chord right there to top that off, and then it does that again. Okay, and then it goes to these power chords. Again, we're on the A, D, and G. So you're on the fifth. All right. And go there. That's on the fifth and the seventh. And then you go to the eighth. And then to the two and four will be started up here. So you can kind of hear the song start to come together a little bit, start to take shape, rather. So from the beginning, the opening sequence, keyboard sequence. So that's the beginning of the song. Now when Billy Idol starts to sing, okay, he's doing pretty much the same thing. It's just real subtle. So I just do one note per chord here instead of doing the whole thing. You know, I just go. So he starts to sing and then you go. Just kind of right on that A string on the second fret. Then it goes to the open A. G on the low E, and then open E. Then it goes, it does this little change. See, on the fifth on the A, fifth, open A, second fret A. So these are the same chords, right? And but when he's singing the verse, you don't want to be, you know, you have to have inflections. It has to be subtle when he's, you know, on the verse part, right? Let the singer have his space, right? And you don't want to override everything. So let's take it from the top, all right? I know this is a little bit more advanced, but it's a great song, all right? So here we go. Then it gets kind of quiet and you do the. See what I mean? So you have to, again, I get my tracks from karaokeversion.com. And if you play along with the track, you can hear when the changes are. It's just open A, G, E. Goes that again. Goes through that like, I don't know, two or three times. We'll play along with the track here in a second. And then starts to build up. And then it goes to this. I love this riff. I'm sure I'm not playing this exactly like Steve Stevens is doing, which it's, you know, but it's still hitting in the right key, you know. So I just do it the good old power chord way on the two middle strings on the seventh. I'm sorry, on the ninth and the 11th, all right, on your two middle strings. And, all right. So what I do is I go like a. Okay, all right, so. I've seen Steve Stevens play this live, and he doesn't do it like that. He does it some other way, but it's still in the ballpark. I mean, it still sounds cool to me. It works. So you're doing like the power chord on the two middle strings, G and the D, and you. All right. So when I let go, I'm just fretting the two middle strings with my first finger. Right? And right there is a 5 and a 4 on the two middle strings. So it's a power chord. And you slide down one whole step. Let's see. Bar the 7th right there. So it sounds weird, you know, but when you're playing with the song, it's awesome. It's just a really cool melodic phrase that he's doing, and it's really cool. So that's pretty much the whole song, and that's it. Rebel Yell, right? So, and then when you go to solo, you want to be in like the, I guess in the key of E, I think. That's just what I do. I mean, it's just, you know, as long as you're in key, do what you want. But this is where I do it. So I'm up here on the 7 and 9 in this box here. Right, and then I go up what I call an extension, which is on the high E, you know, because when you get in that box, go to your extension, and then you can move up there to the 17th on the high E and B. So that's what I do. So I just kind of do my own thing right there. You know, I think it's good to improvise sometimes on songs. I mean, not sometimes, all the time. Have a couple of landmarks in there if you can, but then do your own thing too. That just kind of puts your own spin on it. That makes it fun, you know? So that's the song. Let's go ahead and play with the track. Thank you. Okay, now we're going to go back to the single notes verse. That's Rebel Yell. A couple mistakes here and there on my part. I'm trying to move around here. I got a lot on the floor. Tripping up everywhere, but you get the idea. The things you go through to make a video. Wow. So anyway, hope you enjoyed that. Until next time, stay cool on your stool. This is Joe for the Joe Wins Project. God bless. Keep rocking. See you later. Bye-bye.